Okay, folks, see, we're back with you on YouTube. My apartment got cooled down a little bit, so I could take this opportunity to turn the air off and try to get a couple things accomplished. We're going to be using this car in the weekly challenge. It's a Lotus 311. But I think the first thing that we're going to do is see what this new to my garage 1974 GT is all about. It's almost at the top of the B class starting out. Looks more like a Lotus than it does your traditional Ford GT. It's really light. He's only 1,680 pounds, so that's going to be a plus. Rear wheel drive, which we will change that. We're going to go the all wheel drive route so we don't have to struggle with the handling as much. But let's see what kind of upgrades and tuning we can do on it. We'll look at the perks first. 5,000 car collection influence. Skill multiplier builds twice as fast. 7,500 skills influence. 2 collisions to break a chain. Speed skill, 20%. Sideswipe, only 10%. More for combo skills. Passing skills, 20%. Drift redrift skills, 30%. Air skills, 30%. Percent increase in an event finish influence. And the last thing perk we're gonna get is the 10,000 skills influence. Percent over 10 races and dirt racing doesn't really appeal to me, so we'll skip that. Let's see what's locked and unlocked in tuning in the B class. Gearing's locked. It comes with a 5-speed, but I think with the race transmission that we're going to be putting in, we'll get a 6th speed. Alignment is not locked. The anti-roll is. Aero's locked, brakes locked, and differential. So let's go to the upgrades. We'll swing all the way over to here. And do the all-wheel drive. Engine combinations. We have a six-cylinder 3.2-liter. Turbo Rally at 1.6-liter, or a 2-liter four-cylinder turbo. And I know these two are going to be the lighter weight ones, but I'm going to put this one in it. And it really pops us up. You put a turbo on it. Do the downforce on the front and the back. Since we only get this thing that's not as ugly as some others. Tires. Not much choice here. We could. But we will put the radial / snow tire on there. Go down here to widen the track. That's taken care of. Is there a nicer wheel that we can put on there? Not much weight savings, but we'll do this. And now for the tires themselves, we will go and widen them out. And go into the transmission and change that. Rear differential. Drive shaft, race clutch, and now we come here to the brakes, upgrade those. I don't have to worry about the springs themselves, but the sway bars were locked, so we'll unlock those. Is there any weight savings? Thing's pretty light. Letting this shave 118 pounds off, might as well do it. Go under the hood or wherever the engine is. Airflow. Ignition. Camshaft. Valves, block, pistons, exhaust, what happens if we try and upgrade the turbo? It pops us out of the S1 class, so we'll leave that alone. About the intercooler. Do the intercooler, oil cooler, flywheel, and I guess the only thing left is the fuel system. So we'll upgrade that. So that puts us to the top of the S1 class, which is okay. Spending 85,450 credits. Buy and install the parts. We increased our weight because of the, mainly because of the, I guess, the engine. But it's still very light at 1,745 pounds. Horsepower is at 661. Lateral G's 1.7. Now I'll put the evil tune numbers in, lower the tire pressure. the sixth year now. It's do look symmetrical, but we'll lower the final drive so we stay off any sort of limiters or anything like that. Our estimated top speed is 226. Acceleration is kind of slow. Exactly sure why the springs have no spring rate to them, so let's pump that up front and back. I think we can get away with this ride height of 5.5 inches. Actually, the rear, that's the lowest we can go, so we'll bump the front back up a little. And we're gonna bump up the damping a little bit. Favor the front and lower the pressure a little bit. And put the rear differential numbers where I want them. And that should do it for the tuning. Estimated top speed is now just under 230 miles an hour. The braking stats look halfway decent. Look inside. Of course, in 1970, this is what things look like. On the road, dude. We'll keep it on the road. What the hell? actually feels pretty good. Feels a little bit tail happy. Looks like the cars are getting the best of me here. Hitting everything out here, it looks like. Now he said the acceleration wasn't all that impressive, but it's not too bad. Let's go ahead and enter this drag race here. See how we do here. Oops. I have the difficulty down from a street scene thing that I did earlier. Weight versus the power of the other cars, but it looks like we're doing pretty good right now. You have that bend coming up that looks like we handled it alright. So now it's a cruise to the finish from here. Bad. We almost cracked the 50-second mark, which is over 7 seconds faster than the other cars that were in there. Got this one here, and anything goes. That's Edinburgh, Festival to Edinburgh, over 16 miles. So we'll go ahead and do that one. Didn't exactly want to stop. Not exactly sure what was wrong with the brakes there.
Oh, it's a handful right now, though. It's a handful. It's a handful, folks.
Amazing how you're on the side of a tree and you can't get going. Well, Eagle, you sure started this race out in style. Well, maybe we can recover and get out of last place. Ho ho! job on the suspension. It's not exactly handling things too well at this point. When it gets out of control, it gets out of control. I know what you're thinking. So far you're saying, "Evil, we're not impressed." But I think this car's got a lot of potential. A lot of potential. It is so lightweight that it's going to be able to take on a lot of cars in racing. Check point. And it looks like we're gonna do no better than 10th place, folks. A lot of them in this race. We were able to get to the front at least. Can we stay there? Not exactly sure why there were no brakes. Definitely helped the suspension, but I think the how light it is makes it very attractive to race. For the S-Class, it's got nothing to be ashamed of as far as top end goes. 74 GT70. It's got a numerical name on it. GT70 from 1970. Car we're getting into. Looks like we got to do a little bit of work. Looks like we got to do a little bit of work here. A little bit of work. Feel more comfortable with all-wheel drive. Put the radio on there. The race trans in it and unlock the rear differential. I don't think we have to worry about anything in here, do we? We got the, yeah, it looks like that stuff's done. I think under the hood we got everything situated. So, we're spending under 30,000 in credits. Now we can go back to tuning and fix a couple of things. Okay, our estimated top speed is 209.9, so like 210. I went ahead and left the arrow in the mid-range, so okay. Chapter 2, Bonkers. Embrace the spirit of Lotus, light and fast. Earn a total of 9 stars from speed zones with your Lotus 311. 9 stars from speed zones. at that speed zone. Let's take a look at that. Okay, so we got 3 stars there. Or is that the wrong one I'm looking at? That's the wrong one you're looking at there, Evil. You gotta look at that one. 105, okay, so we got 2 stars there. 2 stars on that one. 2 of 9 so far. 2 of 9. Oh! Maybe that should have been 2 stars there. Might have been a couple more stars there, I'm not sure. How many stars is that now? 145 is 3 stars there, so where does that put us? We have how many stars now? 6? We have 8 stars, so we need one more star. Should have given us what we needed there. So the next chapter is Chapter 3, Duck and Weave. Use your superior agility to earn 15 ultimate near miss skills. Well, the only place we can get ultimate near miss skills is on the freeway. And we need 15 of them. 15. Oh. Man. Look at the Forzathon shop over here. They got the Formula Drift Ferrari in there. If you don't have it, now's a good time to get it. And they also have a Mustang Unicorn. That's also something a must-have. I got them both, so I don't need them. But there's a look at the Forzathon shop. Now for the 15 Ultimate Near Miss Skills. And the easiest way to get ultimate near miss skills is to go against the flow of traffic. So on the freeway, we will be going against the flow of traffic at a high rate of speed. Evil, if you hit him, it's not a near miss. How true is that? I think it flashed and said that we completed the chapter, so let's pull over and see if we did or not. Okay, chapter 4, beep beep, coming through, hey beep beep, that's my license plate. Draft and pass opponents in your Lotus 311 to earn a slingshot skill in an event. Okay. That's only need one. Only need one slingshot skill. Well, if you weren't driving like a lunatic, Evil, you could have missed it. And run this three lapper in here to get the uh Okay, it says that we are done. Gotta do something, folks. Gotta do something. Nope, it did the wrong thing on me. Alright, gotta do something real quick. They definitely got us beat in top end in this thing, but maybe we can use our nimbleness to our advantage. Our nimbleness. Says we're in 12th place right now, folks. Don't believe it. We're in first. like our top end, the top is 213. Is it going to click to 214? 214? Do I hear 215? 215 going once? Nope. Creep back down. Not exactly sure why we sort of spun on that bend there. Hopefully we'll still manage a podium out of this thing. As long as we don't have any more poor driving by evil. Not that it feels like an interior, but this is the interior view in our open air Lotus. Dash looks nice. If I can do this bend a little bit better this time around. Well, at least we didn't spin out. I haven't driven this thing that much because it doesn't have the top end that I like, but it's kind of sporty. Has nimbleness to it. It even hits guardrails at a nice pace. Only joking on that one, folks. That was another evil screw up. Took care of that. Got the weekly challenge under our belt. We simply call it Track Toy. And the trial is not going to get done this week. We'll skip the autumn games and the other seasonal events. We'll skip those. So next time you'll see me is for the winter season. And for 50% completion, we'll go after that 77 Escort. Looks like it's set up for rally. That's going to be, and we may participate in the trial since it's that special Jeep Wrangler that we can auction off. Don't really see anything else. But now I think we'll head back to the castle and put some cars up for auction. It's going this direction. It might be easier to spot what I need to auction. It doesn't make any sense to auction now something that's that cheap. For some reason, these Porsches don't sell in the auction, so I'll skip those. Two of these, but this has the unique paint job on it, and I think I'll hang on to the, both of them. So we won't auction that. I tried auctioning this before and it didn't go. We'll try and auction it again. Bump up the starting price, make it 6 hours, folks. You got 6 hours. 6 hours for that Nissan. Something else, I do believe. This McLaren. I'm going to put this up for auction. One of these 720S Spiders. Six hours. Got some repeaters here, but I don't think I'm ready to sell any of these yet. I tried auctioning off this Levante once, and it's under $100,000, so it doesn't make much sense to do it anyway. Lotuses don't go well at the auction either. These rally fighters, I got three of them, I can't get rid of them. So, if you want me to auction those off, leave a comment, folks. Leave a comment. Guess I can put one of my Lexuses up for auction. $20 million. Holy moly. Let's see if we can get it. Lancies don't do much at the auction, so we passed by those, but I do have this this here, because I got a second one of those, so we'll auction this off. 2008 Revention Forza Edition Lamborghini. I do have two of these GTRs, so we'll go ahead and auction one of these off. $6 on that. I think that was it as far as cars we're going to auction off, folks. I do have this Agera that I got in. That's a repeater, so we'll go and auction that off. Get much for those, huh? Oh well. So, other than putting out a another video in my music series, that'll have to do it for this week on Horizon 4. Hopefully you found it interesting, and thanks for watching, folks, and we'll catch you in the next video, and bye for now.